Hello friends, welcome to Learn Positive with Pradeep Kumar. If you are seeing my channel, please like, comment and share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon. Strength of material, unit 1, chapter 1, statics of particles, solution for problems, class 8. If you want to see my previous videos, please visit my channel and see all the videos and don't forget to subscribe. Two forces P and Q are acting at a point O. I wrongly mentioned as Q, but it was O, as shown in the figure. The resultant of forces is 400 Newton and angle beta and gamma are 35 degree and 25 degree respectively. Find the two forces P and Q. Now see the diagram of parallelogram. The point O has in x-axis the force was P and in y-axis the force called Q. In middle of that, the diagonal was R, R equal to 400 Newton as given. And the angle between Q and R is beta, it is 35 degree. And angle between P and R is gamma, it is 25 degree. Now, we are going to add the beta and gamma, we get the alpha. We are convert this parallelogram law of force into triangular law of force. So, see the right hand side diagram. The angle between P and R is 25 degree and Q and R is 35 degree and the angle of A is 180 minus alpha. So given data is resultant equal to 400 Newton and beta equal to 35 degree and gamma equal to 25 degree. To find force P and Q. Now in solutions, we using sine formula, Lami's theorem, and we know the angle of alpha is beta plus gamma, that is 35 plus 25 degree equal to 60 degree. And the formula is P by sine beta equal to Q by sine gamma equal to R by sine 180 minus alpha. Now we are taking the formula of P and Q to find the P force. So P by sine beta equal to R by sine 180 minus alpha. Now transfer the sine beta from left to right, it becomes multiplication. So P equal to sine beta into R divided by sine 180 minus alpha. Now substitute the value of beta, R and alpha. P equal to sine 35 degree into 400 divided by sine 180 minus 60. The value of sine 35 is 0.573. into 400 divided by the value 180 minus 60 is 120, sine 120. So P equal to 229.2 divided by 0.866. Now the value of P is 264.665 Newton. Now we find the value of P. We have to find the value of Q. So I use the same formula as Q and R. The full formula is P by sine beta equal to Q by sine gamma equal to R by sine 180 minus alpha. I am going to use Q and R. So Q by sine gamma equal to R by sine 180 minus alpha. Now I am transferring sine from left to right, it becomes product. So Q equal to sine gamma into R divided by sine 180 minus alpha. So Q equal to sine 25 degree into 400 divided by sine 180 minus 60. Now the value of sine 125 is 0.422 into 400 divided by 180 minus 60 is sine 120. Now the value of 0.422 into 400 is 168.8 and sine 120 is 0.866. Now we have to divide. The value of Q is 194.919 Newton. Now we find the value of P and Q forces. We have to go for result. The result forces P equal to 264.665 Newton and the value of Q is 194.919 Newton. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up, and if you have any doubt, please comment on the comment section and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you friends.